Hello again, Interwebs. Welcome back. My name's Tethys, and today we're continuing our playthrough of Stardew Valley. Last episode, we ended up getting our chicken coop along with our chickens. As you can see, we've got a little bit of an area built up for them. And I believe they take, like, 5 to 8 days to fully mature. So, in the meantime, in between time, we need to go... And I'm gonna go see about getting Robin to build a silo, because unfortunately we don't have anywhere to store, hay. And as far as I know, we don't start getting hay from grass that we're cutting with the sickle. Unless we have a silo, which is annoying, but what can you do about it? Unfortunately, nothing right now. So let's just quickly go and poke around here. See what we can grab on the ground while we wait for them to open up. And, this little glittering rock here is part of one of the, care packages or bundles in the community center. And that's the reward for, I believe it's for clearing the fish tank. Or the aquarium. It's so you can pan... minerals from the water. You get a pan from, I believe it's the mayor, or from, I think it's Willie? Is it Willie? Let's double check. Yeah, from Willie. But, that'll take quite a while. You need to go through the whole entire year, I believe, in order to get all the fish that you need, and it is quite a bit of an undertaking. So... That'll probably be one of the last things that we end up finishing. The first thing we'll definitely end up finishing is, the pantry? No, it'll be the crafts room. Yep. We do need to go take our cave carrot in there. Because we do have one of those. Hopefully it's not too much money to get a silo done. But let's find out. 100 stone, 10 clay, and 5 copper. Okay. 100 stone. I think we have something very close to that amount, if not actually that amount. The thing we're gonna need is the clay, and I think we have a couple pieces already. So let's go take a look. Thankfully, it's not a huge chunk of change to get done. Which is good, because I don't want to be spending too much money. Okay, we have 2 clay, 90 stone, and we need 3 more copper bars. But thankfully we have copper ore. Actually, we'll just get all that refined. Because we've got 4 refineries. And while that's doing that... need clay. And the 10 stone. So let's pop on over here to our little stone quarry that we have. It's got some copper and some silver, or iron. I don't know why they went with iron instead of silver, since they go copper, iron, gold. And in fact, gold is supposed to be a lot more brittle and not as strong, so it's interesting that they decided to use gold as a higher version when they probably should have gone gold, copper, iron, and then iridium, which is what we get from the skull cavern. Okay, let's just break all of these so that we don't have to worry about them later. There we go. Okay. Now, I'm just gonna quickly take a look here at how we get clay, because, let's see here, found by digging up dirt, sand, or artifact spots. Okay, so for that, we're going to need our hoe. So let's go grab that. And hopefully, fingers crossed, we actually managed to get that all done before Robin closes the store today. Alright. Boo, ba doo, boo. Sources from artifact. Oh, there we go. Alright, good. So we can do this. Ooh, two already. Just need six more. I'll fast forward this part so you don't have to watch it. Okay, so I thought I'd just kind of pop back in here really quickly while I'm looking for spots to get clay, because our green beans finished growing, so we're just going to finish that bundle up. And there's a reward, some speed grow, and that makes everything grow about 10% faster. This is the first time we've also finished a bundle, and that should open up... Yep. The furnace room. Which, I don't think we need to go over and take a look at it. No, we don't. So we got the blacksmith bundle, which is one bar, which we can actually just finish right now. Must be- oh, right. Can't do that when it's, from the inventory. So yeah, this is a really, really easy one to finish. So... just, the fire quartz is a little lower down in the mine, but we've already found frozen tears before, earth crystals, pretty much everything at this point. The slime is just gonna be tedious, but that's about it. I like to finish this one first, though, because as I said, it's easy and it opens up the bridge to the quarry where there's a bunch of different, stone and whatnot. Oh no, never mind, that's minecarts, which gets us around the town faster. I forgot about that. Alright, so we got that done. And now we're going to go and continue our search for clay, so I'll be back in a minute. Okay, so after tearing up everything, I finally found enough clay. So let's get that silo made. Build it. And we're going to put it... shoot. Yeah, let's put it there. And now that we've got that building, I also managed to pick up some artifacts, such as a fan, a chicken statue, and a trilobite, as well as a prehistoric shovel. So that's four things for the library, which is awesome. So we're gonna go and put those in, and hopefully we end up getting a bit of a reward for that, otherwise, whatever. I think what we're going to do is go poke around in the mine tomorrow. So let's donate. And I like to put the artifacts down here. Chicken. Oh, two. Okay. Okay. This got us two things. A chicken statue and a knight on Eco Hill. So some nice little ornaments for the house. It's not bad, actually. So let's go pop back to the house. We still need to... do we? I'm trying to remember. I think we need to water the plants. So... oh! Almost, wasn't even paying attention for that little artifact spot. The worms... if you see worms on the ground, they tend to be little artifact spots, or even just, like, that's where I get a lot of the clay from, too. So, it's usually a good thing just to dig them up with the hoe whenever you see them. Because you never know what you're going to pick up. I've got hair on my glasses. So, pop on back home here. Okay, yeah, we do need to water the plants and also water the kitty. Hello, Fluffy. Zayoga. Yo has water. That has water. And what we'll end up doing is going on a big gathering spree for the hay that we'll need to fill up the silo. Because it's good to have a bank of them, because you never know when it's going to rain. unless you pay attention to the TV every single day. And then you never really know if it's going to, once winter hits, it becomes pretty costly to buy hay, because it's like 100 per piece, which really sucks. Spreading weeds have caused damage to your farm. Okay, so we got normal amount of luck. And it's the first day of summer. So, there goes our plants. Which is fine. The silo will be started today. Let's quickly clear out the strawberries here. I believe now we can plant our melons, which will be awesome because they actually provide quite a bit of income. And we can plant the starfruit seeds as well. Okay. Oh, I almost forgot. Let's go put this inside. Just nice little pretty geode. Be cool if you could get them in different colors, though. I'd like that. Now, as for... Oh, kitty needs water. And we now have full-grown chickens! Bark, 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 bark. Thankfully, chickens don't go through, grass very fast. It's the cows and the pigs and whatnot that eat in one go, but they take about, each grass section takes 3 bites from a chicken to deplete it, and the chickens only take 1 bite as far as I know. Okay, now crafting. We have... Ooh, we could make a mayonnaise machine, which would be awesome, so... Once we get the, melons and the starfruit planted, we're gonna head down into the mine. See if we can find a couple earth crystals. Should be able to, it shouldn't be that difficult considering the fact that they show up at the early levels, especially where we are. And I'd like for these to grow pretty fast, just so you guys can see how it works as well. So, let's put the melon seeds. And the starfruit. You haven't encountered any crows. Oh well. Yeah, let's ship one of the eggs, just so that we know what the price sells for. We also have... Okay, we do have enough wood for 3. Yep, okay, awesome. We could just go into the mine right now, after I deposit all of this, because there's certain stuff that we're not going to need. Like the watering can and the axe. We'll keep the hoe just in case we can... In case we come across any artifact spots. Otherwise, I think we're ready to go. And artisan goods are really great because they, I think, with the mayonnaise machine. Mayonnaise machine. Turn some into mayonnaise. A regular egg sells for 50, so it almost quadruples the sell price of 1 egg. Oh, what's this? Little berry bushes? Nothing in them right now, I guess. And I am going the long way, because I do want to see if there's any more artifact spots in the way that I don't want to miss. And since it's summer, we want to start foraging again, so that we can finish the summer forage bundle. Although it doesn't look like... Those look like they just got... flowers on them. I don't think they'll start having anything until fall, which is when we get blackberries in the early, in the early days of fall. We got one little thing, a sweet pea. Anything? Any artifact spots? Not that I can see. And this time I won't be selling anything that I forage unless I have multiples of it, because I don't want to have a repeat of the leak. So let's go 15 and see how that goes over. Now remember, we're looking for earth crystals, and they're usually just laying around on the ground. They don't usually have a node that we need to mine from. But now I need to find a staircase. So unfortunately, I have no choice. Even just one would be nice, because it's not like we can't do 3 eggs in a day. It only takes about 3 in-game hours, which is 3 minutes of real time, for the mayonnaise to finish producing. So even just one earth crystal would be nice. Got a lot of... Damn it. No, you don't. Bug off. Thank you. Ooh, lots of copper. At this stage of the game, we really can't have enough copper. Later on, it'll become a little redundant, and it's only like when we want to finish little bits and pieces of refining gear. Such as, like, the wool, the cheese maker. If I remember correctly. Let's just poke. Nope, nothing there. Okay, so we're not gonna waste any more energy. Really wish I had a couple grenades right now. Probably should have brought those. Was not thinking. Oh! You drop that. Ooh, quartz. Okay, good. So we can use that at the bundles for in the community center. And since there's nothing else really, let's continue down. Nothing up there. Bunch of copper, some quartz, the slime, which I do want to kill because I want to get those 99 bits of slime for the community center. Well, that's unfortunate. Boo-ba-doo-boo. Oh, maybe there's something here. Might get lucky and... Okay, nothing there. I want to go to the center here because sometimes they do have stuff in these levels. Oh. That would have sucked if we couldn't get through. Damn it. I did not mean to do that. Whoops. Ooh. Not earth crystals, unfortunately, but some topaz, which will at least make this whole venture a little more on the worth it side. Those sound effects for that bug are just annoying. We got a stairwell, so we don't need to worry about wasting any energy looking for one. Oh, no, you don't. Ooh. Okay. Those blocks, from what I gather, are, like, random. They'll drop pretty much anything. I could be wrong, so let me know if I am, because I'm not necessarily sure. And yeah, I could look them up, but the only reason I'm looking other things up right now is because I kind of know whereabouts things are. Oh, an earth crystal! Awesome! Alright, already this trip became worth it. We'll just continue looking here. Oh, another one! Perfect. That makes our mayonnaise making a lot easier. No one loves you. Now, while, the, general levels have, like, between, like, level 10 and level 30 in the mine, they'll have a certain amount of gems that spawn, but, I found some areas definitely have a higher chance in those certain levels, so, like, level 15, it'd have a higher chance of spawning an Earth Crystal than level 10. So, it's a good thing to kind of keep an eye on those parts of the map, or the mine, for what spawns things more often when you're looking for it. So 23 is definitely a better result. Oop. And we are working on getting our combat level up, because then we can start making better bombs. Oh, speaking of which, cherry bombs. Alright, so we got that stairwell there. It looks like nowhere else to go, so down we go. One more Earth Crystal? Could we be lucky enough for one more? And then we can make mayonnaise in 3 hours instead of six? Or instead of having to do all the egg making over six? Anatin? No. So, let's do this. Bombs are also a great way to get a lot of stone, if you have a surplus of them, or a surplus of materials to make them, and you don't want to make anything else. They're really great for gathering stone. The only thing that bombs don't work on are those big, big rocks, the ones that even I can't hack my way through right now. Okay, I want to grab that topaz before we head up. Quickly check the other side of this room here. Nothing from him. And I don't think there's any Earth Crystals on this level. Nope. Okay. Well, we're not leaving empty-handed. We got out with 2 Earth Crystals, 3 Topaz, an Amethyst, some Quartz, and a little bit of Slime to start off our gathering for that part of the bundle. And once we get back, we can make 2 mayonnaise machines, and we're gonna keep them inside the chicken coop, because I don't like leaving the refining stuff sitting out and about on my farm. I find it makes it really unorganized looking, and yeah, it doesn't look quite organized right now with all the other stuff that's around, but we'll get there. Oh, another piece for the forage bundle. Spice berries. Now, I can't quite recall what the other 2 pieces are, so... Oh, she's still here working on the silo, so tomorrow we'll do a big, I just drew a total blank. A big gathering of, hay. Big gathering of hay. Okay. Let's quickly... What else do I need? I need the wood and the copper. 1, 2. And the wood. And now we have mayonnaise machines. Let's go quickly pop those into the chicken coop. Forgot to water the seeds, but I don't think it's going to be a big issue. They should be fine for a day. And if not, oops. But unfortunately, I don't have any energy. Oh wait, no. I can fix that, never mind. We can do that. I forgot to grab the eggs. Well, good thing, because we're going back here anyway. Just eat some white algae. That'll give us more than enough energy for the watering can. Da-da-da, boop-a-doo, and the eggs, up-a-doo. There we go. We'll go pop these eggs into the mayonnaise machine. And we'll just leave them for the night because we don't have enough time. And while we're at it, do we have enough coal? No, we don't. We'll grab some out though. And we'll just pop these on and get refined overnight. Alright, that was a pretty productive day. Not bad, not bad. Considering we spent a little time just trying to grab a specific item from the mine, so we got lucky finding those two earth crystals, and we've got a bit of a lucky day as well, so that's also good. And now, what I want to do is out. Oh, I need four more coal. We're gonna grab 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bit of a lucky day, so let's go and get those geodes cracked open. And we'll get an iron bar here so we can go put that into the community bundle. And what else do we need? For that. We need... Oh shoot, right, we didn't need an earth crystal. We still have the quartz. We've got a solar essence, so we can go do that. And we've got an iron bar. So let's grab that one solar essence that we need. And we've got the iron bar. And we're working on the slime balls, which we only have 8 of right now. And, oh right, we were gonna do a quick gathering of hay. And that should hopefully start filling the silo. Yep, there we go. Awesome. So now if our chickens have to spend a day inside, they're not gonna go hungry, and we don't have to waste 100 gold for each of them. So 300 in total every time it's raining. And it seems like this place has quite a bit of grass, so it's awesome. Plus, you know, doing this also kind of cleans it up a little bit too. So it's kind of a win-win. Right now it's like, see, we've got 48, that would have been 4,800 gold just to get all that. And it took like, what, 10 seconds? Now I think it's up to 250 hay that it holds. I could be wrong though. But even if we overgrab that much, it's not going to matter because it's going to go right into our inventory anyway now. I do find it a bit annoying that we have to, like, buy a silo to start gathering the hay. And you could say that, well, it's because it requires almost nothing to do, which is fair. But by the same token, if you haven't... made the time to go and do that, and you've been focusing on other things, it can be quite a bit of a nuisance just to go and grab everything for it, especially the clay at low level. Because you don't really think, oh, the clay is going to be used for anything unless you go and poke at the store. But I think for a lot of people, the first thing that they're going to have their eyes on is that chicken coop. And I know for me, when I first started playing, I had no idea what the hell I was doing, so... That was also, that would also play a factor in it, I would imagine. We've got a artifact spot up on our little stone quarry. I wish you could buy more tools, so that you could kind of put multiples of them in certain areas, in case you forget to grab it out of one box. Oh, another chicken statue. Lovely. We don't need that, though, so we're just gonna sell that. I don't think it'll bring in much money, but it's worth it, at least. And I can't go that way. But we're gonna go up this up there, because there is more grass, and I want to grab it all, because once winter hits, it's all gone. So whatever you stockpiled, or didn't stockpile, you're stuck with. Ooh, and our coffee beans are grown, which is awesome. And those, as I said before, the first one that you grab is the one that decides between no quality, medium quality, or high quality. The next three beans are always no quality. So what I like to do... Oh, okay, went behind the scarecrow. Yes, I understand. Thank you. Anyway, totally sidetracked. Squirrel. The third one will always have no quality, so what I like to do is plant the no quality, or the low quality ones, and keep the high quality and the mediums and sell those ones, because it ups your production, and since they last through the spring and summer, it's totally worth it to do. Alright, so, let's take a moment here. I will fast-forward this. I just want to clear this way out. Awesome, and we got some more eggs laid. So let's quickly exchange those. And let's also fill up the hay bales for the chickens. And I'm thinking we could actually go and get another one, because this holds four. And we do have enough hay already stockpiled in order to warrant having a fourth chicken. Let's go and grab the other chicken. And now mayonnaise sells for 100 gold each at low quality, so the lowest quality you can do is 190 instead of 50. So yeah, almost quadruple the price. And she's not at her table. Wonderful. Well, I guess what we'll have to do is go to the mines, then. Which is fine, we're gonna go the long way around, but first I wanna water the, melons. Okay, and we're just gonna quickly pop in here, too, because I wanna drop off all the stuff that we can. Okay, so the only thing that we're missing right now is grape. I forgot that the, summer bundle is a little smaller for foraging. And the pantry, that's the summer crops. So tomatoes, hot peppers, blueberries, and melons, which we are working on right now. Now we're just gonna pop on over to the furnace room. And we're just going to put in the solar essence and the iron bar and the quartz. Geologist, there we go, there's that, and that done. Okay, 10 batwings, super easy to get. You get one or two usually every time you kill one, and they're really easy to kill. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go pop down into the mines and see what we can get for the rest of the day here. Hopefully we come across a grape. So that'd be nice to finish that bundle off really quick, but it doesn't look like it. Oh well. Yeah, we'll go at 10. Why not? See what we come across. I do kind of wish that the music would play all the time while you're in the mine, instead of just, like, during certain ones. Because it is nice music to listen to. If we come across an earth crystal, that'd be cool. Although I think those are a little further down. Oh, really? I failed that hard? Go away. Stairwell, please. There we go. Oh. Killing slimes, 'cause I need their corpses. Mining experience goes up, or mine, not experience, our level goes up pretty soon here. Because we're at what now? We are at 4, and at 5 we get to choose a perk from 2 different ones. I can't remember what they are, but we'll figure those out once we get it. See? I love it when this music's playing. And then it stops. Oh wait, nope, there it went. Yeah, see? That specific, little rock there gave us an amethyst instead of a topaz this time, so I'm pretty sure that it drops a random one. Ooh, we got a lot of copper here. We're gonna grab it because I'd like to build a couple more refining forges. Almost midnight, but we'll see what we can grab. Nothing there. Slime up here, so we'll kill that. Yes, an earth crystal. Awesome. Now, I know I'm being greedy at this point. Could I just get one more? That'd be really cool, because then I can have 3 mayonnaise machines. Monster Slayer goal complete. See Gilfrey reward. Alright, well, we killed the prerequisite amount. Ooh, and a second Earth Crystal. Ah, me feel happy. Okie dokie, now we need to get our butts out of here. And fast. Yes, I need to leave the mine and I need to run toot sweet. Toot. Yeah, we gotta run pretty quick here. We should be fine. We've done this before. We know what we're doing. Bunny rabbit. Oh, grapes. Awesome. Alright, so that bundle's done too. And then we need a frozen tier and a fire quartz. And those are further down. So those are just going to be whenever we end up getting to that part of the level. Two earth crystals. Oh, golden, gold star grape. Awesome. You know what? Let's just sleep. The heck was that? That was weird. There was an what? An earthquake? This is embarrassing. I lost me lucky purple shorts. I'm telling you because if you find them, bring them back to me discreetly. I'll pay well. Thank you, Mayor Lewis. Okay, so the earthquake happened. What does that necessarily have to do with me? Like, what does that affect? Oh, we don't even need to water. Sweet. No watering today. But we do have to feed the chickens. And we have to grab our mayo, so. Works out. Let's get that. And that. Mayo. Oh, chickens are already fed, I forgot about that. Go put our eggs in the mayonnaise machine. And pick up the other egg. And we need 15 wood. And a copper bar. How much you want to bet I threw out the amount of wood that I needed? Nope! Haha! I knew it. I knew I didn't throw it out. I really did. And one copper bar. And now we're just gonna pop on over into the chicken coop again. And plop down the maintenance machine. Oop, there we go. Now, before I end this episode, we're gonna pop over to the community center, and we're just gonna go and finish that little spring bundle. Or not spring, summer foraging bundle. Now, I know this has been quite a long episode. I wanted to kind of make up for not posting yesterday. So, hope you enjoyed. I've been joining it. I lost track of time, so I enjoy this game quite a bit, and it's nice to be playing on a new file where I know what I'm doing instead of fumbling around and going with a very disorganized farm. Now we should get summer seed bundle. Yep. Well, there we go, and. We have an earth crystal. Oh, is this gonna open the... Nah, it did open the bulletin. That one's got a little more specific stuff that we'll be able to get later on, but not right now. Like, large eggs will have to go in the pantry, and those will take a while because we need to get the chicken's friendship with us up quite a bit. But, like, chef's bundle, a lot of that we can't get right now. Dye bundles, we could get that and that, Aquamarines are a little lower in the mine. That we can totally do right there. Can't do that right now. Oh, well, would you look at that? One thing done, and we didn't even know. And then we'll just pop our little earth crystal on in here. There. Okie dokie. And now I'm just going to end up walking back home, so... Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you've enjoyed this kind of extended episode. If you liked what you saw, go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button. It helps me, and it helps you guys keep up to date with the videos that I post. Try to post 2 videos every day, and I'd like to do some more videos, but let me know in the comments section below what kind of games you'd like me to play, because I want to play what you guys want me to play, so thanks for watching. Bye! Probably the best thing we came out of this with. Oh, and I hope these are big, big slimes, obviously. And sometimes they split up. Mostly. Most of the time they will split into small slimes. Absolutely aggravating. Like, they get all the